I gotta tell you something. And you was like, what? But you started smiling because I think you already knew what I was going to say.
I did. I already felt the whole vibe. Like I said, from day one, I felt it. You was like, I got to tell you something, but you can't tell nobody. I said, you don't even have to tell me.
And then I said, is it weird that I always want to be wherever you are and know what you're doing? And you was like, no, that's not weird at all.
Maddie. I know I like to tell the story of how we met because I think it's so interesting. We my homeboy needed a ride, remember?
Mm-hmm.
It's a video shoot and went, gave him the ride, boom, walk into this crib. I'm like, okay, who is this? I ain't know nobody, nothing. I'm just sitting there at the step like, okay.
So I used to watch you all the time on Empire and I always said like, I wonder if you like girls. No idea. I didn't know. I didn't even know your real name. Because I Googled it before. Like, what's Bre-z's real name?
You were stalking me.
Yeah, low-key.
Wow. That's new. That's a new one.
Yeah, I just said, what's Bre-z's real name? And your real name never showed up.
It's a secret.
Yeah, so I come out, and I'm like, damn, I just seen you on TV. What the hell is she doing, like, here? So weird. So then we just had this connection. I don't know, we just became friends for like a whole year.
Literally, you turned out to be the best friend I ever had.
Oh, that's sweet. Really?
You did, yeah, what? We had a ball, we was together every day. You was taking me to do stuff, I never did. I'm like, what, I'm at Six Flags, I'm like going to concerts and stuff. And yeah. I was like, I'm this whole famous person, but I really didn't have no life.
And
yeah.
You instantly was helping me out at the video shoot.
Yeah. I think that's just like, it's in my nature to just
help.
Like a natural caregiver, natural nurturer. So I'm just like, yeah. Whatever. I'm like, I don't care who I am at that point. Like, right. If somebody needs help, I'm like, what's up?
Yeah.
I don't never like to see women working too hard either. So there's that.
Okay. Okay.
You know what I like about you most? Is that you're not afraid to just sit in the house and watch TV with me. Because remember when we met, you was always doing something. We was always doing something.
Uh-huh.
And I just, you know, I love to be in the house watching TV. What was the last thing we watched?
The Nun.
Master of None.
Master of None.
So we watched Bodyguard first. And
then
we watched Master of None.
Bodyguard, then Master of None.
It was cool. I mean, it was cool.
That one episode, though, with...
Lena Waithe?
Yeah, when she was bringing her girlfriend.
Two girlfriends.
Her finally coming to try to tell her mom...
Our girl was
that she was gay.
I'm gay.
You what?
I'm gay. I've always been gay. But I'm still the same person.
Yeah.
That was actually dope. I mean, her, Angela Bassett, crazy.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, what was your experience? Did you, like, tell your mom? Like, hey.
Like, did I have a coming out story?
I guess.
That's what, I guess it seemed like they're on the show.
Mm-hmm.
No. I just was who I was, and I brought home whoever I wanted to bring home.
You never said nothing?
No, I never had a discussion at all.
Your
mom
was in the cut, like, she just... I'm talking all that Spanish.
I think in her head, she was just more of like, it's just a friend, is what she probably wanted to register in her head. But
she
wanted to believe that, you know, she just thought I was going to marry a guy, have kids.
With me, my mom, I think I was in like eighth grade. My mom found a letter in my pocket from a girl.
Shut up.
Shit. Your mom washing your clothes in eighth grade. She found
Jeez.
It. You know, that thing was folded up with the tuck back.
Did you make the hearts? Did you make, like, different
designs? I didn't
designs?
Make anything. Somebody wrote it to me. A girl wrote it to me.
Oh, okay, okay.
And it was a 2-page letter, and she just told me just how amazing I was and how much she cared about me.
Eighth grade?
Eighth.
Damn.
So what was your favorite moment?
I'm going to say I couldn't stop laughing.
You was dying. I was like, oh, my God.
When Dev, that's his name, right? Dev?
Mm-hmm.
When he was yelling across the table to the grandma, Ernestine, like...
So, what is that? Let me say, do it.
No, you do it. Mm-hmm. No, because you do it better than me.
Mm-mm.
He called her grandmother, right?
Her grandma.
Yeah, grandma!
She went to China!
She went to China, grandma.
Mm.
She lived in Shanghai for 2 months for work, and a lot of people thought she was Beyonce. And this one restaurant even put her photo on the wall, but she didn't have the heart to tell him.
But that was so funny because he kept keep repeating it. So what did he say?
I think it was the same moment at the table when the first girlfriend came back, when they worked it out.
Oh, Lena, yes, and the girl, yeah, worked it out. Oh, that was sweet.
And she was at, yeah, she was at the table. It might have been the China. It might have been this. It might have been right before that because she started rubbing her back.
Mm-hmm.
And Angela Bassett character was like, what the, like, what y'all doing? But I think Lena had got, or Denise, she had got comfortable and forgot where she was at. And it was like, oh, slow down, Turbo.
Yeah, because she wasn't ready to see her daughter do all that.
She wasn't.
She was not ready
she
for
wasn't.
That.
Look, you can be lesbian if you want to, but when you come up in here, you're going to respect my house.
I think parents find it hard to just accept who their children may grow into. You know
yes.
what I mean? And if it's not who you want, then now it's like, ooh, respect my house. It's like, girl, calm down. You just so mad that I want to be a,
right.
a lesbian and not an astronaut.
Right. Cold lesbian.
Well, I'm gonna take me a young lady to the moon. You better believe that.
Or when did you know you were going to propose to me? Like, because you threw me for a loop. I had no idea. You was even ring shopping.
Oh, man. Honestly, man, from day one of us meeting, I already knew. And like I said, I said to myself, I'm gonna get me one. And what I meant by that is I'm going to get me someone as kind, as loving, as sweet and as caring as she is. I hadn't even heard you speak yet. Mm. But I knew, I'm different, but I already knew. You know, so when I speak on you, people can't believe it. I'm like, listen, I don't know what you got
going on,
but
over
it ain't that. You know what I'm saying? But it's just, I feel like we all know what we're capable of, but it really takes one or a special person that makes you comfortable in being everything you know you could be. That I know what I want. I knew you was what I wanted. And I know this, what we've created so far was what I wanted. So I said, you know what? I'm gonna do it. Her birthday coming up. I just was like, you know what? Let me, everything that she's been doing, everything she wanted, I'm gonna do it for her. You know? So I went and got you every dozen roses for every
you
age.
You gave me more.
Every age you
yeah,
was.
Yeah.
And I
you gave me 35
said,
plus dozen roses.
I got tired of hearing about your car and that mess. I said, I'm going to get her a car. You know, and I kind of just wanted to create your perfect little fantasy moment. I wanted to bring that to life. So, setting you up a photo shoot. You never had a shoot you wanted. And I
first
think you're
like,
so
you
beautiful.
You made me so mad.
I set you up a photo shoot. Well, first I sent you away to a resort for the day.
Yeah, and I'm like, where am I going? You was like, babe, just 12 o'clock. Driver's going to be outside. Get you a little night bag.
Because I wanted you to relax. You don't know how to relax.
I don't.
You don't know how to sleep in. You ain't got nothing to do today. You don't know how to just chill. You got to get up, make coffee, go for a walk. I'm like,
yeah.
Okay. I gotta force you to calm down and really enjoy yourself and enjoy your day. It wasn't about me at all. I may have to come with you. I wanted you to have all that. And I knew you had never had like just a brand new car. No miles. I wanted you to have something that was yours, not nothing. You had so much taken from you in your last relationship. And I wanted everything this go round to be yours. And I wanted you to know what that felt like. And I really feel...
You're trying to make me cry. And I'm not trying to cry.
I really feel like And I told this to my mom, I told this to your dad and my dad, and I just felt like this was God working through me. I actually sat and I heard you pray.
Don't do that right now. Do not.
I heard you pray for things that you were working so hard for, and you didn't understand why it wasn't happening. And I said, in one day, I took whatever amount of money it took and tried to answer, not even try, just answer every prayer that I heard you praying. And that, to me, that was God.
Don't do that, babe.
That was God working through me. And I appreciate it so much. I don't regret it, because I felt like you had done so much and you had worked so hard. And I just feel like everybody deserves that. And, you know, if God ain't leave me out, he damn sure wasn't leaving you out. The grandma, the aunt. What was the aunt when the boy was yelling and the aunt was like, don't you yell across this table one more time.
Grandma Ernestine, your yams turned out really nice this year. You had a little nutmeg? I said your yams turned out really nice this year. Did you add a little nutmeg?
She added nutmeg. Don't you ask another fucking question. Nutmeg, cinnamon, whatever the hell. You know what go in the damn yams.
I think that, though, her mom had to see the difference in women
right.
to accept it. I think her bringing home that nipples and toes, and then the other girl went to China, I think it was kind of like, okay, well, if I gotta be okay with this,
let me get the well-educated one.
Let me go with Slim Jim over here.
Right.
Because the girl was just kind of like, you know, just one of those millennial type, you know, all on her phone. Oh, let's take a picture. Oh, it's Instagram.
And the whole
dinner
table, she was like this with her phone. Like,
what? In the black household, Thanksgiving is a sacred time. You better not talk out of turn. You better just have a good time. Don't get out of line. Don't say nothing disrespectful.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, and mind your manners when you at the table. So, I think the fact that she came in the house and didn't do that, and everybody was clocking it. I love our future for us. I mean, I think we've grown so much individually. We've grown so much together.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's working. I told my mom the other day, and I said, Mom, God really be answering Chris' prayers. Like,
You said that?
Yeah, I said, I see it with my own eyes. You know what I mean? So to me, it's so important, like, because I know that he's in this. You know what I'm saying? And so when you say you about to pray about something, I'm like, like, I'm saying, trying to ask me.
No.
You be like, reveal such stuff. I'm like, oh my God, he about to show her.
I always pray, you know, that God always kept you centered and calm and focused, because I know where I see ourselves. I know where we are now and where we're going. So every time I feel like, okay, you know, you have so much going on in your head, and I know you're veering off a little bit. I'm like, do not divide us. Mom always told you that, your grandma. Do not ever let nobody divide y'all. And I was listening, and I took it in, and I always pray for that, for no division to come in between us, and to stay focused, to keep it going. Because we're good people, and we deserve it all.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Love that.
Yeah.
For us.
I love that for us.
You
want cheers?
Yeah, cheers to that.
You gonna take a shot?
Oh, you trying to go big on me.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's do our cheers.
Who we cheersing
to? I don't even eat the lime.
Me neither.
You think?
Who we cheersing to?
I'm cheering to you.
I'm cheersing to you.
Well, we're cheering to us.
I love that it's always to us.
Yeah, always. How'd that feel?
I'm drunk. I'm drunk.
No, you're not.
Love you.
I love you too.
I'm still drunk.